Hey guys, Corey here. I've already done a little stretching in this room here. A couple more positions with the power stretcher before I get it down here. First thing, apparently the window had been broken, so I grabbed a piece of glass when I first started, so that slowed me down a little bit. We vacuumed everything up. Let me show you where I'm at now, and we'll go downstairs and look at the room downstairs. It's got a little bit more going on, so it'll be maybe a little bit to learn with it. But hang on. All right, power stretchers are already in place, and I've pulled the carpet one time. We're still looking at some wrinkling in here, so I think maybe one, maybe two more pulls of the stretchers, and I'll have this one all ironed out. This is what you're looking for to learn carpet stretching in a room that's shaped like this. This is your friend. Here, let's go downstairs and we'll take a look. We'll surprise the guy down there. He doesn't know I'll record, I guess. The guy upstairs does. We'll take a look at the room down here. I'll show you what's potentially challenging about it. Right here, and most of the issues are, I'm a YouTuber,
okay.
So right here is where basically all of the stretching needs to happen, right here in the traffic area. You can show this a little better. It looks way better on the phone than it does in person. Can't really show it, it's all wrinkled through here and stuff. And it's basically, it's what I call legitimate because it's in the traffic area where it should be. So we should assume that it was installed correctly. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna pull the carpet up to here, not over there. I don't wanna pull it up over there if I don't have to. I should be able to pull it tight enough from here to pull those wrinkles out and leave that attached. So pull all the carpet this direction and that should get it. But you never know, you have to always figure in the fact that everything could go to hell in a handbasket and be here all day. Anyway, back upstairs I go. All right, what has happened now is I moved the stretchers two more times, so three different pulls in this room, and looks like I'm gonna get this much off. I'm moving down the wall right now, so I'm gonna finish that up and cut it off, and we'll head downstairs. I'll show you how much I wind up cutting off here in just a few minutes. All right, this is what we got off here. That's a sizable amount, and it's due mainly in this room due to the elasticity of the carpet. I've done other jobs, I think this week, that was wrinkled up as much, and I got about a quarter that much off it. It's the carpet's just not that stretchy. This stuff's really stretchy, so got a lot off. All right, gonna move this whole show downstairs and pick it up down there. All right, I have placed the stretchers and pulled the carpet one time. So this is what we're looking at after one pull here. So I think I'm gonna do this about three times, maybe four, just so you know you've got the whole thing pulled out flat. See, this is where this is laid down flat. The carpet's kind of pinched up looking. Sometimes what'll happen, if it stays wrinkled for a long time, this particular carpet will try to delaminate and fall apart because it's getting wore irregular, I guess, in that area. Anyway, pull the carpet a few more times and check back in. That was four repositionings of the power stretchers here. Moving along the wall. And that's what I'm getting off of there. Still has kind of a wrinkled look to it because it was so wrinkled, and those areas are actually creased now. They're straight now. They still have that need to be vacuumed look. All right, I'm going to finish this out and see what I cut off. All right, this is how it all turned out. About the same as the upstairs room here. And that will actually finish out the week. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. See you on Monday. God bless.